back to TalkNorth.com. Thank you for listening. If you can, please download before you listen. It helps our business. I'd also like to thank our producer, Brandon Morton, and let you know if you'd like to sponsor this program or any of the programs on the network, you can reach me at jsouhan47@gmail.com.
Why does Kirk Cousins hate Minnesota? I mean, that's really the only question that matters in this Vikings offseason. Don't worry about free agency or the offensive line or the new coaches or the new offensive approach. Why does Kirk Cousins not want to spend his winter freezing his butt off with the rest of us? I'm really offended, Tim. I think we're going to get Tim's take on this. This is the Viking Update Show, part of the TalkNorth.com podcast network. This is our ground level beat and columnist view of the Minnesota Vikings that complements Jeff Diamond's show, which is more the executive view. I recommend listening to both if you're a Viking fan. You can find everything at TalkNorth.com. Subscribe at your favorite podcast app. Thanks to Brandon Morton, our producer. Please download before you listen. Follow us on Twitter at TalkNorthPod. And if you'd like to advertise with us, you can reach us at TalkNorthPodcast@gmail.com. Large loyal audience for this show, as well as some of the other shows, but this is one of the most popular shows on the network. Thanks to our sponsors, Twill and the Edina Galleria, Mississippi Pub, FixologyRepair.com, Tony Hoaglund, your State Farm agent, Champlin. Let's get right to it. Kirk Cousins tweets that he likes Miami in the winter, and here's the funny thing. Every Minnesotan wishes they could travel to Miami in the winter, but many Minnesotans choose to be offended by this.
Can you imagine being a pro athlete with the recognition of Kirk Cousins and being on social media? I mean, it just, it boggles my mind, the kind of comments that he got on this tweet that said, in 2010, I was mad King James for leaving Cleveland, but I've been in Miami for 5 minutes and I totally understand. I mean, how innocent is that tweet? And how many Minnesotans were complaining about the weather over the past 2 weeks. They want to be in Miami. They want to be in a warmer climate. You know, I was a couple weeks ago. It was great. The weather was terrific. So I'm just boggled by, to me, it seems like this attitude among Minnesotans, like we are the only ones that are allowed to complain about the weather. And anybody that is an athlete that is maybe not native to Minnesota can't complain about the weather. I don't get it. It would infuriate me if I were Cousins or anybody else that is just tweeting some innocent things and trying to have fun with it.
That's right. You have to do what this show does. Rip Kirk Cousins when he screws up on the field. That's what you rip him for. Maybe I'm ripping for some of the way, for the way he kind of treated Adam Thielen on the sideline. We don't mind ripping Kirk Cousins around here, but don't get offended by people who want to be in warm weather. I'm leaving tomorrow for a trip to Mexico. Doesn't mean I hate Minnesota. I chose to move here. I chose to stay here. I turned down job offers elsewhere. I've made my life here. I've raised my kids here. But you know what? I want the heck out of here. Get me out of here as often as possible in the winter, just like they would, all the people ripping Kirk would do if they could.
How many times did you see posts on social media, Facebook, Twitter, whatever, Instagram, where people were talking about how tired they are of shoveling their driveways, blowing their driveways, you know, the traffic on the highways backed up. And I mean, the fact of the matter is, I think what brought this on is people, Vikings fans, are frustrated that, you know, the Vikings spent so much money on Cousins. He comes in, they don't make the playoffs a year after Case Keenum led them to the NFC Championship game. And, you know, most of the comments were, well, you can stay in Miami. They need a quarterback, too, and that sort of thing. But, you know, I give Cousins some credit. He, you know, he had a tweet several hours after that initial one that said, you know, that escalated quickly. And then followed up on Wednesday with a picture, you know, from the highway, one of the highways in Miami that said, can't believe King James left Cleveland for this Miami gridlock. So, he had a sense of humor about it. He found a good way to diffuse it, but, you know, I'm just amazed at how thin-skinned some people are about anybody that complains about the weather in Minnesota.
God, I give him credit. That's pretty funny. Good stuff from Kirk. Let's get into some actual news. Adam Thielen's agent, by the way, Jeff Diamond works with the agency that handles Adam Thielen and Blake Cashman, which include led by Blake Barrett, who's a really cool dude. Thielen's agent is now talking about an extension. And we knew this was coming when the Diggs deal got done.
Absolutely. I mean, all along, the past 3 years anyway, we've been talking a little bit about the how much, Thielen is not making compared to what Diggs is making on his new extension. And so I do think that something is going to get done in the next year. But the issue is cap space and other needs that are a little bit more pressing. And so, I was happy to hear what Blake Barrett's had to say. I think he presented things very professionally, basically saying, Adam deserves to make more money compared to the wide receiver market out there, which is true, but he understands the Vikings cap situation too, and is willing to work on something with them. And basically said, Adam is not the type of guy to hold out, which I think is absolutely true as well. So I think Blake Barrett's handled that absolutely the right way. And I'll add this too. You have to realize that when Adam signed his contract, he was not producing like he is now. And I think it was good for both sides. The Vikings obviously saw something in Thielen before he started producing at the 900,000 yard level a season, and worked in some incentives there that have brought Thielen closer to market value, but still not quite there yet.
I have some thoughts on this, some other kind of thoughts and ramifications. First, let's thank Twill in the Dining Galleria, twillmn.com, T-W-I-L-L on Instagram, friendly shop, great products, always new lines of clothing coming in. Great traditional stuff, also some stuff that will probably surprise you. Check out Twill, head to the Adina Gallery, and have a good shopping experience.
Jim usually doesn't like to shop for clothes. I don't like it when he shops for clothes either, because he used to buy stuff I'd want to throw out. That's why I'm so glad he's found Twill in the Adina Galleria. He likes shopping there because of the comfortable environment and the friendly staff. He finds clothes that actually fit him properly and are high-quality brands that will look great for years, whether he's golfing or working. Our favorites so far are Peter Millar, Johnny O, and Barber. We spend our money at Twill because we love the clothes and we love the no-pressure shopping. Drop by Twill in the Adina Galleria for the best shopping experience and best clothes you'll find in the Twin Cities.
First of all, I really like Blake. Obviously, I like Jeff Diamond. I think Blake's got a good heart. He's not afraid to say, he's not politically correct. He doesn't say just things that agents should say. He's willing to put himself out there. I really admire him and the way he does it. It's a reminder that not all agents are easy to demonize. Because sometimes they take the brunt, just like lawyers. Sometimes they take the brunt of doing what's best for their client, even if it's unpopular. So not all agents are bad. Blake is a bit. Blake, I really like what he does. The other thing I will say, though, is that sometimes the team has to win. Everybody knows that if a player performs, he's going to get paid, and he should get paid to a certain level. But sometimes the team, they, as you said, they recognize that somebody is on the way up. They sign him to a reasonable a deal that, is good for the player at the time and has a chance to be good for the team if the player performs well. Well, that eventually the player's going to win in the negotiations if they keep performing like that. But there's nothing wrong with a team having a team-friendly contract once in a while.
Well, I mean, the fact of the matter is that, when Thielen signed it, he wasn't a 1,000-yard receiver. He wasn't even a 900-yard receiver or an 800-yard receiver. He was just one of these guys that they saw a lot of potential in to work his way up, in the receiving ranks. And so the team, I think, took a calculated risk when they signed him. It wasn't a big deal at the time. It was a few million, but the incentives, I think, are something that both sides were wise to put in. And eventually, sometimes things work out for the player where you'd say, okay, if he didn't perform or he didn't turn into what you thought he was going to do at the time he signed the contract, he's still getting most of that money. If he signs a decent contract that has some signing bonus attached to it. Now, if he overperforms or, you know, exceeds expectations, as I think, you know, Adam did in the minds of most fans anyway, that, you know, a lot of times the agent's going to come back, try to get his client to hold out. I mean, we saw what happened with Le'Veon Bell, which I think was handled ridiculously poorly by Adisa Bakari, who is his agent. And, you know, then Le'Veon this week finds out, okay, they're going to allow him to be a free agent. And he says, free at last, free at last. But yet, you know, the guy turned down $13 million plus to not play last year because he wasn't happy with his contract. I have more respect for agents and players that kind of see the bigger picture. And I think that's what's happened with Blake and with Adam, seeing that, you know, the team also took a chance on him. And you could argue overpaid him in the first year of that contract based on their projection that he could turn into somewhat close of the receiver that he has turned into. So I think it was a fair contract at the beginning where both sides took some risk. And I think eventually he is going to get an extension that pays him more. But I appreciate the fact that neither Adam nor Blake are trying to put pressure on the Vikings and saying, you know, we're going to hold out and this is a completely unfair deal.
Yep. Speaking of a former prominent receiver, underrated receiver, it seemed at the time, Charles Johnson. Remember Charles Johnson? I thought he was going to be the leading receiver for this team. I thought he was going to be a really good player. And he ended up having one nice season and then kind of disappearing. He is now leading the AAF in receiving. So my analysis that he was a receiver on the rise wasn't completely wrong. He was I just got the league wrong.
Well, yeah, exactly. He, I think he had 192 yards last weekend for the Orlando franchise, and it's the Alliance of American Football, the new league that started up, kind of a what people think may turn into sort of a developmental league for the NFL in Johnson's case. So I think he's getting close to 30 years old. So, you know, it may be hard for him to catch on with a NFL team, even if he continues to lead that league. You know, he might get a shot in summer camps and that sort of thing to try to earn a roster spot. But the timing of it combined with, you know, with what we just talked about with Thielen's contract was interesting because when I was writing up a little summary about what Johnson's done in the AAF, you know, his best year was the year before Thielen and Diggs really broke out. So 3 years ago, I think it was, Charles Johnson had, I think, a 450-yard season with the Vikings. And then after that, you know, Thielen comes on board. And let's not forget that one of the reasons Charles Johnson came to Minnesota was because Norv Turner was here and Johnson was kind of a practice squad roster fringe guy in Cleveland before Norv Turner came to Minnesota. So, you know, a lot of it has to do with, you know, personal relationships, past experiences with players. And, you know, I don't think Charles Johnson is going to ever be a 600-700 yard receiver in the NFL again. But I brought it up because fans may remember him from several years ago with the Vikings. And, you know, I just it's worth noting that guys can have success even after, you know, maybe their NFL career kind of dwindled out a little bit as it did for Johnson after his days with the Vikings.
It's also worth pointing out because we point out the Vikings mistakes when they make them, other team NFL teams' mistakes. It's also worth pointing out that we get them wrong sometimes too. I really thought he was going to be a 1,000-yard caliber receiver, and he wasn't. I was wrong. Let's get to some free agent speculation and news. Do want to thank Mississippi Pub, MississippiPub.com. They have ribs on the weekends. They have brunch on weekend mornings. They do private parties. They have a view of the marina and the Mississippi. They're open 3 to 11 Monday through Thursday, 11 a.m. to 2 a.m. Friday, 9 a.m. to 2 a.m. on Saturday, 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. on Sunday. And, you know, really good comfort food, fish fries on Fridays, ribs on Saturday. Check them out, 4455 66th Street East in Invergrove Heights. Great place, especially if you're going to the Vikings practice facility for any reason, whether it's training camp or their museum. It's just an easy 10-minute drive out by the river. Check them out. All right, so what do we got on the free agent front right now?
Well, I've just finished up doing a ton of research and writing on position by position look at all the free agents or the top ones anyway.